discount into the majority.
That's right.
Let's say Lowndes, Tiff, and Ware voted against it, and the other 15 counties voted for it, a majority.
As long as they reach 50% plus one in voters.
Probably those three counties, which are probably would be three donor counties in this region, possibly Coffee, they could kill it, the entire region, if it was a large turnout against it.
Large county, like, we could kill it here for everybody.
Right.
Depends on that.
Yes, ma'am.
Absolutely.
All right, Clay, who decided to split it? It's not gonna be on the November, but in July, on the budget.
In the original law, it says July. Now, they're trying, in the last special session that they just finished up in August, they asked to move it to November, but it went nowhere in the legislature. That might be taken up again. We aren't sure if the legislature's gonna do that, but right now, it's gonna be the July election in 2012.
It was the legislature that decided that on the...
Yes.
Ma'am, state your name, please. Jean Arandula Valdosta.
Pardon?
Jean Arandula Valdosta.
Okay.
Robert?
Do you have a question?
Okay.
Robert?
I was gonna bug you first.
Oh, okay.
John Spiderski, who are the three non-voting legislative members?
Jay Roberts from Osceola, Ellis Black, and then Greg Goggins from Douglas. Robert?
Yeah, I'll speak with Liz, since we don't want to get into the other political part of it. Just as far as the Lowndes County list, just for information purposes, I'm Robert Yost. I do not like the list, so the ones that are gonna be approved.
Yep.
I question if constitutionally in Georgia, it's gonna be legal for somebody in any group of counties to vote my county a new tax. And I do know that's what the first war was fought, is taxation without representation. Now, here's my concern. If you look at this list, what I see going on is the federal government and the states are both broke. They're shifting the burden down to the local counties, hence a region. So what we're gonna be doing, and you're right, this money has to be spent in this district, but those other funds that we've been getting don't. So now, we have no control over where those funds go.
Those funds would have to be still spent in our district because of congressional district balancing is still in place. So the current federal funds and the current state funds, those do not change. Those still have to be spent here because that's what current state law still says. They still must be spent here.
And my concern is, we're gonna take on state road repairs, which is not the county's job. We're gonna take on interstate exchange repairs, which is not my county's job. We're gonna take on the responsibility of other people that we're already paying taxes for to do. But we're gonna take that over, and that other tax money's not gonna come here. A lot of people in government don't know this, but we're in a recession. And we need to cut money that's going into government entities, cut them out, and let it stay in the business community.